Where am I?
Hello everyone, Shadefire here, and welcome to part 2 of Let's Play Trescom Ops, the Trespasser mod. This is TC Isle. Now last time we got on a hot air balloon and sort of drifted away on it, and now we're on a tropical island. If we head out into the water here, we can see how we ended up here. Now, I was intending to do these levels blind, but unfortunately a variety of errors and problems with this level means that I'm doing this for the third time. So, not really a lot of surprises left, I don't think. Also, one of the other reasons I'm re-recording is because the blind video ended up being like an hour and 10 minutes or something of sort of meandering around. And there's not really that much to see on this island. There's a lot of empty space. So I'm going to give you the whirlwind tour and try to cut down the length a bit. So if we swim out here, we can see that our hot air balloon is how we got here. We, I guess, crashed into the ocean, probably because of that pterodactyl, which does not animate well. Oh, another thing, I had to turn down the draw distance quite a bit because if I maxed it out on this level, it would crash while trying to load in further areas for some reason. So, it's going to be pretty foggy. Anyhow, let's swim back to shore. Alright, so first things first, we're going to head to the left here from where we started. There's not too much on this side of the island that I've seen, so we're just going to head over here, check something out, and then we're going to head back. Also, I hope you like that damage sound, because we're going to be hearing that a lot, since even though she's not taking fall damage, she's taking minuscule amounts, I guess, whenever you're trying to jump up these hills. So, you can hear that a lot. These hills are also a big pain in the ass to climb, and this whole island is very hilly like this, so that's half the reason it took so long to get through. I've yet to been able to get over this hill without sliding to the ocean. I can hear someone's chowing down over here. We've got a raptor eating a pterodactyl. And no, I know it's probably not actually a pterodactyl. It's probably a pteranodon or one of those varieties. I'll admit that winged dinosauroids are not really my expertise. So he's just chowing down over there so we can leave him be. Not really sure how a pterodactyl or whatever ended up dead here. Clearly he didn't kill it himself unless it was hobbling around on the ground. The other thing I wanted to come over here for is this crate. Just some random crates washed up on the shore, but of course you can't grab them. In one of them, however,
six left.
There is a fully loaded Ruger Redhawk for some reason. So I guess someone was just shipping loaded guns around. Anyhow, that's the main reason I came over here is to grab that. And let's head back to where we started. Actually, on the way over here, I totally noticed this little life preserver from the SS Minnow. I'm trying to remember if there's any ships from the movies with that name, but nothing coming to mind. Unless it's maybe the ship from the beginning of... Well, not the beginning, but the sort of first arrival on the island in Lost World. The Costa Rican boat. So a little ways up the shore from where that raptor was, back in the opposite direction, there's this kind of area of toppled palm trees. I don't know if this is just, you know, the result of a storm or what, but there's also not much in here. Honestly, I think this level is pretty heavily backloaded. All the interesting stuff is on the far side of the island from where we start. If we wander around here, there should be some local wildlife. Somewhere. Ah, there we are. Another pair of compies just snacking away at... What do we got here? It's a bit unclear because it's buried. Of course, they will take a snap at us and probably even follow us if we stick around. So we're just gonna keep going.
Surreal.
Well, we are in the Pacific, so I guess it's not too surprising that there's a World War II bomber here. This is what, a B-17? Of course, since there's no World War II guns in Trespasser, there's not really an armament or anything in here. There is, however, this screwdriver. And we're actually going to need this later on, so we're going to hold on to it.
Six left.
Thankfully, it's not the only screwdriver in the level, so it's not like, hey, you have to find this spot to progress, but you do need a screwdriver. There's not really anything going on in the tail. Got a turret mount knocked off here. Presumably these guys got rescued or something, because I don't think there's any skeletons around here. And obviously there wouldn't have been dinosaurs here when they crashed. Alright, let's continue down the beach to the next point of interest, which you can vaguely see off in the distance there. Oh, shit. Where'd that go? I keep forgetting that it's left mouse, not right mouse to aim. Right mouse just makes you drop your shit. Alright. I had to bump down the draw distance again because something over here was crashing the game, so now we're at minimum draw distance. Anyhow, on the way over to that tower we saw in the distance, there are these Moai heads for some reason. Don't really think we're in quite the right part of the world for that. We've also got someone snacking over here. First, it might look like a raptor, but see, he's got a tinier head. I'm not completely certain what species this is supposed to be. I want to say Gallimimus, but I think it might be a little too big for that. It is, however, a herbivore, as you can see from him clipping through that bush. He's got the right thing, though. He's got the big legs for running, little tiny head. So if it's not the Gallimimus, it's probably something fairly similar. A lot more broken trees around here, probably from a hurricane or something. Alright, let us continue on our journey down the beach. Another thing I forgot to mention is the coconuts. There are coconuts all over the place. If you pick them up and try to crack one open, you can hear that they make a basketball sound for some reason. Now, Trespasser, of course, did have a basketball item in it, so that's probably just them using that sound effect. The question is, why would you decide the basketball is the best sound effect for a coconut? I'm pretty sure just a generic wood sound, which might sound a little off, would still be better than a basketball. Need to make ourselves a net.
Six left.
Alright. So we actually had to turn left and start heading up inland to get here, because the rest of the beach is just hills, which these raptors have now gotten stuck on trying to get to me, I guess. I'm going to say that this is a terrible design for this whole island, and I really wish they had maybe considered it better, because Trespasser does not do these hills very well, of course, with the rather lacking friction system for the physics, so there's a lot of sliding downhill in this level, and that's not a lot of fun. Having to struggle up the hill. Okay, so we got the raptors down there, though they might have as much trouble as we did getting back up. Got this tipped over truck here with a shotgun, so we're gonna toss our Red Hawk, I guess, and grab this.
Eight left.
And that tower we were looking at is just over the hill here. You can see there's sort of a path leading to it. That path will be important. We'll come back to that to find the way to the rest of the landmarks of the island.
Ah.
You can see there's sort of a lighthousey thing over here. And of course, the bridge is broken. We've got to hop across. You can't just walk up that hill because it's too steep, and you'll just slide off. Some more dactyls. So this is the only door, and it's locked. Thankfully, they have the neat enough programming to do this. Which you can see turned it into a different door. One that could be opened. Because, you know, presumably we blew the lock off there.
All gone home.
Got a generator here. We've got Earl. I'm not sure what this stands for. I'm assuming it's emergency something. But if we prime this baby... It's the Jenny going. Lighthouse digest. There's also a flashlight. I think there's a way to turn this light on. I'm pretty sure I've seen it in a screenshot or something, but I have no idea how. And Trespasser doesn't really have a lighting engine that requires flashlights, so we'll toss that. Now we can head up here. Oh god, these are so awkward to navigate in video games. I mean, it doesn't help when you are constantly tripping over the steps over your own sphere feet. Since Anne, of course, does not have legs, she just has a giant sphere where her legs would be in terms of her actual movement. So, last time I went up here, for some reason I got crushed by that, so I'm gonna duck when I head up here. You think maybe we'd have to signal or something using the lighthouse by turning it back on, but as far as I can tell, there's not really much point to coming here. I don't have my gun. I definitely do not want to drop that. Because trying to find where it rolls off to is not going to be fun. That's pretty much all that's going on in the lighthouse, as far as I can tell. If we had the draw distance maxed out, I could probably see some of the other points of interest drop there, but this map doesn't like that too much.
Looks like 7.
So I'm going to head back down this path, which actually leads to a variety of other things, as I mentioned. So let's just skip ahead to that. So following this path further inland leads to this bridge over a river. And, of course, the bridge here is also broken, and if we fall in, we'll have to swim all the way down. So, the best way to get across is to spastically hop, because that is the best way to avoid hazards like that. And over here... Oh, okay, so the path splits here. I'm trying to remember which way we want to go first. I believe this is a dead end, so we'll go here. This is like a little logging site. With another new dinosaur, which is pretty neat, actually. Hey, buddy. What you doing over there? I was going to throw my gun at him, but that's probably not a good idea. You might recognize this cheerful little fella, especially from his head tilt. So, that's the Dilophosaur. He is pretty well programmed, I think. He's got the little neck frill. He spits at you. I'm not sure if the spit does anything other than make the screen say spit flies, but it's pretty cool. I think he's probably the best one they added, even though, obviously, Dilophosaur, not the most scientifically accurate in Jurassic Park, since they basically made up the whole spitting and neck frill thing. And also, Dilophosaur is actually quite a bit bigger than a person. Seems pretty confused by us.
6.
How confused are you now?
5. One less threat to the American way of life?
I did it for Dennis. Alright, so with the spitty face over there dealt with, we can actually poke around a bit. There's not really much to see. There's a crowbar. Call Gordon Freeman on some dinosaurs. Except not really, because it doesn't even have the sort of melee attack thing that some items have.
Five shots.
Flails it. Got some barrels just hanging around. Nothing in them. And there's one item of interest here. If we look into the actual cab of this truck, oh yeah. Except we can't grab it from the side, so I'm gonna walk around. This is a goddamn chainsaw. Oh, Jesus. It is a huge pain in the ass to try to get this thing to function, because she holds it really awkwardly, it's heavy, and you can't pocket it, because it's heavy. Now, you might think that this is just, you know, a neat little thing. Hey, look, a chainsaw, you pick it up. But if you hit spacebar, if you look there, the teeth are actually spinning. Now, we might find out how effective this is on a dinosaur a little later. Actually, was I doing that wrong? I just want to see if we can actually swing the crowbar. I might not have actually been hitting the right button. Assuming I could find it again. Okay, yeah, you can't do anything with it. So we're going to leave the chainsaw for now, and we're going to continue back down the path to one of the other points of interest, since this is a dead end. It doesn't really lead anywhere if you follow this trail. Actually, is that true? Yeah, that's where we came from. Okay. I got a little turned around there. One of these paths leads us back to the beach, where there's this little pier with some more compies. Hey, little bugger. Got like a sunken boat here. Got some paddles. Nothing really on the piers themselves. They're kind of busted up. But you can see there's something rather large off in the distance. And that's our next destination. And hopefully not our final destination. Got a big-ass beached ship here, the SS Venture, which, if I am correct, is the ship from the Lost World that they used to bring the Tyrannosaurus to San Diego. Oh, he ran off. I was going to try to test something. Where did the other one go? I guess we just scared him off. But let's go poke around the SS Venture. I'll leave our gun here because it's going to be kind of awkward in the tight quarters of the ship. When I get inside, we got to jam ourselves through this hole in the hull. Alright, good thing I wasn't standing there. Helpfully, none of these wheels actually work, so you don't have to like twist them and then open the doors. And in here, we find another screwdriver, which seems like it's way harder to find than the first one, and exists for the same purpose. And we can electrocute ourselves. Now, if you look in the various doors of the SS Venture, there's really not much to see. They're all empty rooms. So we're just going to head straight for the stairs. Actually, if we peek over here, you can see the big empty cargo room. Nothing really interesting in there.
Hello? Anyone out there?
So it seems to be implied that someone has mysteriously locked us in the ship. So we'll have to find another way out, because currently, we're trapped on here. Can't just, go back the way we came, because it collapsed. So instead, we're going to cut across the cargo hold. Which, oddly, does not have any way to open. Usually there should be a big, door there that they would load cargo through. Oh, come on. Trespasser ladders.
Hello?
Guess I can't open that door. You can also hear our screwdriver just randomly clanging against stuff when we walk into it. And then we got the engine room with some InGen crates, which I think solidifies my opinion that this is the same ship. I actually don't remember its name. Like, I'm sure there's plenty of places where you could see the name on the front of the ship, but I don't remember exactly what the name was. So it seems like there's nothing down here, but in fact, we can get out through this ventilation shaft. Now, hopefully we don't have to build a tower of awkward crates here, as they did actually make the vent itself function like a ladder. Just have to get a little higher. There we go. Gotta kinda jump your way up here because you get stuck otherwise. Now this is probably a terrible idea, crawling through a rusted ventilation shaft in an abandoned ship. I mean, it's a terrible idea when it's not an abandoned place and is actually well maintained, but we're very likely to just fall through here and die. It's also kinda awkward to get through here. So this, more than anything, makes me believe that this is supposed to be the same ship. Because not only are these fancy doors here, but if we can get that door open. Also, someone reminded me that you can right-click while left-clicking to sort of launch your finger at a button to make it easier instead of dragging across. So this thing won't start. It's got two blinking lights on it. One of them means we need to shove that fuse back in. The other problem is this pipe here. That's what I was looking for, which was wedged under one of those spinny bits. So now this thing's all ready to go. You can see that these things are all dented up as though the T-Rex busted through them, as it did. No, no, get away from there. Come on. And if you take too long, you have to go back and press it again. Or if you are a little too slow, you'll get wedged into the ground and the doors when they close on you. And this is just the door we got locked in by. And we got all sorts of stuff here. You'd think you'd be able to call, like, for help or something on the radio. We can fuck around with the channels and stuff, but yeah. There's really nothing doing with that radio. Still see that one gala back there. Nothing really else out there. But we got this button here. Which summons another new dinosaur, which kind of looks just like a T-Rex from up here, but is not quite. And that's pretty much it for the SS Venture. Like a lot of things in this mod, or map pack, it feels really pointless. Like, a lot of the things in here just seem, hey, look at this neat stuff we put in. It doesn't do anything, or, you know, affect your progress in really any way, since the only thing we needed was a screwdriver, and we could have got that elsewhere. Go say hi to that dinosaur monster thing. Hey, buddy. You look, actually, he doesn't look as nearly as big as T-Rex. But, as you'd expect, he's gonna fuck us up.
4, 3, 2, 1.
And we don't have any more bullets. So we're just gonna run away. But that there, I believe, is supposed to be a Ceratosaurus, based on the little frills. It's pretty neat. I'd definitely say that the bonus dinosaurs are one of the best things about this series of maps. So, I'm gonna head back to the piers, if I can lose this guy. There's not a lot of weapons, as far as I've been able to tell, lying around on the island. Alright, I think we lost him. So, back towards the logging site. Between the logging site and the bridge, there's one more path that leads inland up the hill. And this is ultimately where we want to go. I guess that sound she makes sometimes when we jump is not actually a damage sound, because when you take damage, she goes like, ow! It's sort of a rough landing kind of sound. You know, like, you don't take damage, but it might have hurt a little bit. On top of one of these mountains, we have a proper InGen facility.
As we left, we vandalized our own locking mechanisms. InGen tolerates no trespasses.
So this is where we'd want a screwdriver, and
that's gotta be what I need.
It is a huge pain in the ass if you did not know that and you go here first, because you gotta walk all the way back and either go to the bomber or the boat and grab a screwdriver so that you can do that.
Yes!
Which, I'm not sure that would work, considering the wire has been cut, but whatever. You might think we're nearing the end of the level, but there's actually a fair bit more. Now we've got, jeez, I can't remember his name now. The park warden gets eaten by a raptor. Clever girl, all that. You can see there's a number. Oh god, it's really hard to hold this thing. It starts drifting around. There's a number at the bottom there. That's a password, a potential password. But we don't actually need that one, I don't think, so we're gonna leave it. Got a big old warehouse. You could climb up there and onto the roof, but there's not really any reason to, as far as I can tell. We've got these broken door controls if we wanted to open the hangar doors. Which, hey, Let's give that a shot, why don't we? Anne's pretty good with her hand. Her one functional hand. Can you even see her other hand? I don't think you. Her boobs are in the way. Let's just put these wires back together, why don't we? Oh, jeez. Well, that was certainly a shocking experience. Alright, let's leave the maintenance to qualified professionals. Back here, we've got some dinosaur pens. And some graffiti. I don't know who came all the way up here to graffiti this dinosaur island, but someone did. I believe a bunch of these are folks who worked on the mod pack, or map pack, I guess. And I can't do anything with graffiti. Sadly, the can is empty. There's a helipad, but of course there's no helicopter, and Anne probably couldn't fly anyway.
And seismic instruments in yellow crates. They set them in the dust as the helicopter rose.
Did we just leave all this expensive equipment behind? Also got this collapsing facility. Nope. Stepped on a piece of glass. You can see it has not weathered the elements too well. But it looks like it's pretty much a prefab structure, so that's probably not too surprising. Looks like a compy x-ray, maybe? Can't even tell what this one's supposed to be. Also kind of weird that this place still has power, but we'll see why that is in a sec. Another card in here. This is John Hammond's card. We're gonna hold on. Oh, no, I didn't mean to throw that. We're gonna hold on to this. Some film here, but you can't pick it up. Can you tell what's on that? It just looks like a screenshot of the level. That's pretty much all that's in this building, unless we go upstairs. Where there are some controls, as well as another keycard for Dennis Nedry, the head programmer of Jurassic Park. And we got this fancy computer system. Pretty sure something here turns this on. Ah, probably the breaker. There we go.
Security system. Looks like that's still active.
So there's a security number we need. And let's see. 03015. I'm pretty sure there's something about my textures that is not turned up all the way, because I've definitely seen someone else looking at this, and it was much clearer. So I don't know if I've fucked the settings with ATX or something. 03015. Okay, let's do this without fucking it up. Using my newfound right mouse powers. Oh, goddammit, Anne. I'm gonna stand a little bit further back. Zero. These are really weirdly positioned. Three. Zero. One. Ah, oh, goddammit. Zero. Three. Fuck. Zero. Three, zero, one, Where's five? Five. What? Okay, it worked. This thing just says loading. I don't know if this is actually doing something. If we go over here, this thing's booting up. Look at all these buttons we can press. Beep, boop, beep. I'm a computer. Help, computer. Yeah, we could wait for this system to boot up. But it's a little slow. It's not quite a Cray XMP. I'll just keep pressing buttons while we wait. Oh dear. Now we've really fucked it. We crashed the whole security system. Let's just get out of here. Portageon over here.
Woo! Like a barn.
Let's just karate chop that door closed. Our real destination is this, like, bomb shelter looking door over here. I'm not completely certain, but I'm pretty sure we need to turn on the security thing before this will open. I didn't actually test it out. Well, that didn't do anything. Open. So you might think that this is the end of the level, this elevator, but no, there's actually still more. Which is probably why this video ended up being so long the first time. Really need some elevator music here. Yeah, that's better. I would check my watch, but man, it doesn't really have one. Just do a little stretches. Yep. Yeah, just, yeah, that's probably how hands work. Do the robot. Boop, 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 boop. The door also dings before we actually get to the bottom. Alright. So now we're at the last part of the level, the tunnels. Which, at first, it might seem like, oh fuck, here's a fucking tunnel maze. What a way to ruin a level, but no. It's actually pretty straightforward, since everything but the right way is a dead end. And we got some mining equipment here, some big old batteries. Okay, this flashlight's actually working. But you can see, not really a purpose to it other than to say, hey look, we got a flashlight to work in Trespasser. Got a shotgun.
8 shots.
We're not gonna need this, honestly.
7.
What we do need is one of these batteries. And you might think, oh, well which one? Obviously, it's the hardest one to find, just like every other puzzle in Trespasser. We're gonna need this, so we're gonna put that on our... Shit. Gonna put this on our belt, if the game will let me. By belt, I mean she puts it on her shoulder or something. Actually, I have one use for the shotgun, so let's pick it up. I'm not really sure why there's a shotgun in the mine, though. Unless they were trying to keep local Costa Rican workers in check. So this left-hand path just leads to a dead end. There's literally nothing down there. The right-hand path, on the other hand, leads to something somewhat important. This is presumably where the power for the facility is coming from, which is, I guess, just like every other InGen facility, powered by geothermal, which is why it's still functioning. You can see there's a bunch of water down here. I don't know if this water is supposed to be here. The raised platform makes me think it is, as well as the pipes. but if we fuck around with these little things, which are pretty rusty, it turns on the water there. And that's about it. I don't think that does anything. The water doesn't rise. It just kind of gets all glitchy like this. I'm staring at that step, and yeah, it's definitely not moving. It also makes it kind of hard to escape. You get kind of stuck on that water. So we're just going to get out of here.
7 shots.
Ah, shit, I dropped my shotgun.
7 shots.
And then we got to walk down the tunnel for a little bit. And up here we pass a couple more dead ends before we get to this area. Where there is a blocked passage with dynamite. Now, I'm not sure why they're using dynamite to blow up this wood that they clearly put there themselves, but there is dynamite. Also, it might kind of look confusing here, and this totally stumped me when we first got here in the original recording. These wires look like they're just going into the ground, and thus you can't do anything with them. But for some reason, they're actually coming out of the ground over here. And this is where you need to use the battery. And only that one battery that's hidden behind the boxes will function. The other ones are duds. Before we set that off... Take a little stroll over here and see there's nothing. Just a cave-in. That cave-in does actually dump you into one of the earlier tunnels, so you just have to walk back. But the first time I fell through that, it actually shoved me through the wall and out of the level. Also, while it might seem impressive that this is all built underneath the existing level, there's actually a level transition teleport sort of thing when you go down the elevator. So this is actually built somewhere else in the map. It's not quite as streamlined as it looked, since presumably you can't do the huge vertical space that it would require. Plus you'd be loading all that stuff, and that would be silly. So, we could just connect these wires and set off this dynamite, but hey, that's no fun, right?
Looks like 7.
Let's just do it the manual way. Gotta be careful here, don't want to get blowed up. Let's line up the sight post. Can't even see it. Okay, there, like that. Perfect.
5.
I love the shotgun just pointing straight up. So yeah, obviously if you shoot it, you're just gonna blow your ass up. And that one had me really stumped because I didn't see these wires for the longest time, so I thought I had to shoot it. Because why else would they give you the shotgun? And I was trying to find like ways to like lean around the corner without blowing myself
7
up.
Shots.
But no. The real answer is you come over here, you crouch, slap these wires down. Oh, shit. Nope, come here, you. Just go like this, and like this. And then it blows up, and we still take a bunch of damage, but you don't die. I think you might die if you're standing up, but, or if you're, you know, a little too far over this way, but it seems like you just take a bunch of damage and survive. So now we're getting pretty close to the end. That's another dead end over there. I hope you're not minding me, not showing off those dead ends, but honestly, there's nothing there. There's not even, like, skeletons. Oh god, that wasn't a dead end at all. I'm a fool. I showed off the dead end after all. There you go, completionists. I say that, but I'm sure there's probably something I missed on the island for the, you know, 5 of you that actually played not only Trespasser, but custom Trespasser levels. And then we got this proper sort of natural cave complex down here. With a beautiful waterfall. Actually, it's just... it's kind of an okay waterfall. average. Maybe even a little mediocre. No. Okay. Down we go. It's a neat little hole, though, that we can look out of. I imagine this part would be a lot worse if Trespasser had a proper lighting engine so it didn't just glow in these caves. Oh, fuck. It's okay, we can go under. Finally, after all that toil, we've made it to the end of the level and our final obstacle. So there's a bunch of diving stuff in this shack. Sadly, we can't, like, put on these flippers or anything like that, because that's too complicated. What we can do is pick up this dive tank, put it on our back, and now we're wearing it. Never mind the fact that there's no regulator or anything to actually breathe out of. We don't need that. Because now we just gotta swim our ass out of here. This part's a bit of a pain, so obviously, Trespasser doesn't have any diving type stuff. You cannot go underwater. So instead, we have to find a trigger point to actually start the dive. There we go. I don't know what that thing on the left is. And then we get, I assume this is one of the only, like, in-game cutscene that Trespasser has. Well, obviously not. Regular Trespasser. And then we got a busted old dive tank here. And we come out of this pool, which is really, really hard to get out of. And this is TC Rescue, the third and final level of Trescom Ops. I have not played this map yet. So, hopefully I can get through this one blind without having to re-record the whole thing. But I've been Shadefire, and this is TC Isle, level 2 of Trescom Ops, custom maps for Trespasser. And I'll see you again with the third and final part next time. Until then, you folks all take care. Oh god, what are we wearing? And what happened to your skin? Ugh.